That's Taj 3 years ago performing with the legendary Carlos Santana. And he was only 10.
That was one that I think I was actually nervous for because I was like, I have to play with Santana.
I mean, guitar legends don't get much bigger than that.
No, no, there's not many. And no, I mean, he played at Woodstock, so he's one of the nicest people I've ever met too.
Taj was only 7 when he fell in love with the guitar at an AC/DC concert.
I was on my dad's shoulders and I was like, I want to do this.
So were you good straight away?
No. So the first time I played, Dad full wanted me just to stop playing because it was so bad. It was like...
Yeah, right.
So, yeah.
Yeah.
By the age of 9, he'd mastered the guitar and a viral video was spotted by Ellen DeGeneres.
I got a call from her and I was like, this sounds like Dory, because like she was the voice of Dory and I completely forgot. And I was like, yeah, Dory, let's do this.
Were you nervous?
I don't get nervous anymore, which is really cool. I know, like, if I mess up in a song, I know how to fix it.
There's a saying that if you make a mistake once, it's a mistake. If you make it twice, it's jazz.
Yeah.
That performance boosted Taj's online profile. But not everyone was happy for him.
I actually used to get bullied quite a lot because I used to play guitar like that.
Because you
play
guitar?
Because I play guitar, yeah.
You know, 20 years before, that would have made you a hero.
Yeah, I know. I would have been the coolest kid in school. But, I used to get bullied because of it.
He had a bad run. It was really hard to watch. He come home and I just saw a pattern changing and it was like he would play till like 11 at night. It was like he just wanted the door closed and just to be playing.
It was like I used to be able to play and express what I was feeling and like let out the emotions through my fingers.
How's your English report coming along?
The family decided to homeschool Taj. This too gave him and his sister Giselle the freedom to travel to gigs here and overseas.
Yeah, Zell plays drums.
Do you guys jam?
Yeah, we play all the time. It's always good to have someone you know on the stage.
It's been an amazing ride for the whole family, Grandma included.
What's she like on the two of us? Does she rock and roll?
No, she doesn't like when we're up too late. She's like, oh, you have to go to sleep, you've got a show tomorrow.
But none of this comes cheap. The guitar Taj is holding is worth 30 grand and he's got more than 50 others.
Yeah. One for never, different songs.
Exactly, right. But there'll be people going, that's outrageous.
Yeah, I just collect. That's the whole point of being a guitarist. You just collect guitars and play guitars and sell guitars.
Doesn't sound like you sell very many if you've got up to 70
sitting.
No, I don't
sell any, actually. I don't think I've sold one.
Of course not.
Taj's mum and dad have had to make sacrifices. They've moved the family into a caravan.
You sold your house?
Yeah. We had a business, a cafe at the entrance, and we had a house and everything. We wanted to set up and make sure that we could give them what they need, and a house isn't what they need. I had to talk to my nan before she passed, and the reason I got upset was because I was very close with her, and she told me one thing. She said to me, you can give them to them when you're dead and don't get to enjoy it, or you can give it to them while you're alive and you'll get to experience it with them.
Back home, Taj is headed back to school, just not as a student.
So now you want to use your music to talk about the issue you really care about, which is bullying. How are you doing that?
So a lot of kids don't like speaking about it.
And I've learned that it's not okay to bully someone, so thank you guys for watching.
I just want to help other people with it in case they are being bullied.
To describe Taj as committed would be an understatement. He spends hours every day practicing.
I'll take your guitar now. This is mine too. Now I have 61 guitars.
You must be proud.
Couldn't be more proud, that's for sure. He's a little boy from Long Jetty, New South Wales. He's 13 and he's selling out 1,500 seaters back to back in Ohio, Texas, Missouri, Arkansas. I believe that he's got the potential to be as good as what everyone says he is.
So when are you happiest?
Probably when I'm on stage, playing in front of people, just making them happy.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's when I'm happiest.
Oh, I love that.
That was great. Absolute dude, Taj is, huh? 13.
It was so sad hearing the stories of, you know, they'd throw his bag out in the rain, they'd jump, throw him in puddles, things like that, just because he's, you know, he had the dreadlocks, whatever. And his parents didn't know about it for a couple of years. But now to repurpose all that.
You can see a bit of AC/DC in this.
Oh, yeah.
There's a lot of that going on. We played some AC/DC. Sadly, we couldn't get the rights to broadcast it.
Oh,
but if you want to find out more about Taj's anti-bullying school tour, there is a link on his to his page on our website. You'll find it there.